It takes a lot of skills for horror and comedy to be blended together in a way that doesn't come off as campy and unbalanced. But Miyuruko-chan, the girl that sees them, has managed to pull it off perfectly though. Written and illustrated by Izumi Tomoki, the series was initially published on the art site Pixiv before getting picked up by Kodokawa for the print release and then Yen Publishing for an English release. It also has an anime adaptation currently airing as I'm making this video right now. Miyuruko-chan follows the daily life of Miko Yosua, an average student who initially seems to be fairly unremarkable, until she suddenly gains the ability to see ghosts. Miko initially begins to notice vague paranormal phenomenon but doesn't seem to pay much attention to it. But the ghosts are not only drawn to her because of her abilities to see ghosts, but it seems that her best friend Hannah has a powerful aura that spirits love to fade off, making her just as susceptible to attack as Miko. Throughout the story, Miko tries to find ways to alleviate the stress caused by her abilities and meet others who can see the spirits as well. Despite how terrifying the situation she finds herself into, Miko manages to overcome her fears and protect her friends when things go south. In this video, we will talk about the manga and the first 3 episodes of Miyuruko-chan, which are released till now. But before diving deeper into this, make sure to subscribe to my YouTube channel so you can get amazing content related to animes on a regular basis, including top 10 listings, breakdowns, reviews, and recommendations. Firstly, let's talk about the manga of Miyuruko-chan. Miyuruko-chan is so far so great. As a fan of both horror and slice of life genre, this series depicts the mundanity of everyday life spliced with the unearthly experiences of wandering creatures on Earth that gives a sense of personal connection to the readers. For the everyday person who may have had metasensory experiences in areas as a dark places or places with creepy atmospheres that have ever evoked that seemingly irrational but heavy gut feeling in them, those types of readers can relate and can rationalize those experiences with the creatures depicted in the manga, which they called as spirits who could be roaming on the earth, all unseen by everyday person's naked eyes. For those who claims to be mystics here on the earth, practicing meditations and rituals to achieve mystical experiences as with a tarot rod or ancient practices, this manga may be a refreshing reminder of their journey practicing such rituals in the modern setting. So in short, in terms of story, it's basically a girl who can see weird creepy shit everywhere she goes, but she goes on to pretend not to see these things. Later in the story, she meets some other people who can see ghosts just like her. But one thing I hate about this manga is that it gets pretty interesting at the end of every chapter and then boom. Then you have to wait for a very long time to read what happens next. Yeah, this is so one of the biggest things that frustrates me about this manga. The style of this manga is really amazing. The author underlines the otherworldliness of monsters by drawing them differently, with expressive dynamic black strokes, as if scratched by a terrific hand on a paper. They seem to shimmer and warp slightly from panel to panel. The rest of the manga is done in a clean, detailed, modern seinen art style that allows for a great contrast. When the monsters in the manga becomes visible, they are very much in space, interacting with the environment, active and aware. They are very dangerous, and the rule of the fictional world dictates that if Miyuruko-chan as much as acknowledge them, they will likely attack, so that they are a constant danger just a hair away, which creates tension and drives the events of the manga. Again, it is difficult to express it believably, but the designs are just so fully realized and so strong that you don't need to make any effort to feel that they are scary, and you don't need to be understanding or to suspend your disbeliefs. The scary and the horror part comes naturally. These things means terrifying bad things that you never want to meet. You can't do anything about it. You just can't. Yet here they are in all the way disturbing glory. The main criticism that can be directed towards the narrative is that the heroine seems weirdly inactive in looking for cure for her condition, but it's also shown that there's not enough info to go by. She expects those ghosts to just go away just like they appeared by itself. There are many chapters dedicated to the initial situations before the character starts to actively move. The initial setup is complex enough and deserves it, however, plus there's also a subplot to follow now and then. There's also a side of the very black comedy to this world, which can come onto the forefront at times. As of now, it is hard to say that if the manga can be classified as a sort of diamond in the rough, since it's still very early for that, and even we are 30 plus chapters in, we are barely scratching the surface. That being said, what can I say for sure is that it has all the ingredients to make quite a really good story, an interesting one too. Not to mention, the art is pretty damn good and creepy. Now if you will talk about the anime part, till now they haven't changed anything from the manga, so it looks like a faithful adaptation of the manga. The visual presentation, however, helps boost Miyuriko-chan from an acceptable diversion into an anime that can go toe-to-toe with other horror heavyweights. The most eye-popping component is its creature design, which takes no half measures when it comes to slapping sloth skin, scrambled limbs, and then hellish ossified face. This technique is very similar of the way of the Jujutsu Kaisen anime handles its own monsters. And that's not coincidence, of course, because Hiroya Ijima, the same guy who was responsible for the most of JJK Curse's designs, contributes to the design here as well. Even in the absence of particularly goals, Miyuriko-chan's overall visual direction is a cut above average. It exercises some of the freedom that comes with the genre, indulging in odd angles and fun illusion for the purpose of setting up its horror set pieces. However, the enjoyment of the Miyuriko-chan is going to be reliant on the tolerance of tasteless cheesecake. Because when the camera isn't gloomed on the ghost or the main characters, it tends to wander close to around boobs and butts and thighs of Miko and her friend Hannah. So those weird camera angles are really making me pissed off, because if I really want to watch that, I would have went to watch something like High School DxD. Why would I watch a horror comedy show? In this anime, I personally think if they could just stop doing that weird fan service, then the anime can really feel better. Except this, the rest is just like the manga, so you already know about my thoughts on characters and the plots of the manga. Most of the ghosts seen in Miyuriko-chan has been a grotesque amalgamation of the body horror. The introduction of two cat spirits alongside the scared man's wife at the end of the episode 2 confirms that Miko has just rotten luck and encountered some of the less desirable ghosts the world has to offer. Miyuriko-chan will undoubtedly continue to play off her reserved reaction for the horrifying sights in front of her. But there's potential for more than just comedy to be worked in some narrative going forward. And I hope that everything will go according to the manga, minus the fan service. If that happens, this anime can really provide a good run for the seasonal anime for the fans of horror and comedy, both. What are your thoughts about Miyuriko-chan? Have you read the manga or are you watching the seasonal anime this time? If you are watching this anime or if you have read the manga, then let me know about your thoughts about that in the comment section down below. And if you enjoyed this video, then don't forget to like this video and subscribe to my YouTube channel, because I post daily anime content about top 10 top 5 listings, anime reviews, recommendations, news, theories and all sorts of anime content on daily basis. So if you enjoyed, please subscribe, and that was it, and I will see you in the next one. Sayonara.